First and foremost, Jeff is an all-around amazing host and guy, and while some of the things he's done in Season 41 have been questionable, the fact that he's had no seriously bad moments as host for 41 seasons that has put his job and reputation in jeopardy proves how good he is at his job, with some fans even saying Survivor will die the day Jeff retires. And while he has been known to be sassy and angry at times, his truly bad moments are few and far between. But in the end, nobody is perfect. So today, let's take a look at Jeff Probst's worst Survivor moments during his tenure as host. His first truly bad moments came ironically during Survivor's biggest season, Survivor All-Stars. Now, to be fair, these moments on the surface aren't exactly too bad. It's just that he handled these situations in the exact opposite way he should have. The moments I'm talking about are Jenna and Sue's quits. After Jenna made the decision to quit to go be with her dying mother, Jeff, instead of absolutely being in agreement with Jenna, proceeded to question her decision?
It just doesn't make any sense for me to be here anymore. So I need to take myself out of the game.
So are you talking about your mom?
Yeah. She's just not any better and things have gotten a little worse quickly.
You're talking as though you're getting information, updates on your mom in
the
last 9 days.
She's my mother and I'm the only child. I got a vibe. I got a feeling that she needs me there. My dad needs me there. Everybody needs me there. I made a bad judgment call. I shouldn't have came. I thought that I could do it and she would want me to, and I was wrong. I should be there in case something happens.
So that's one of my questions. I just want to understand exactly why you're leaving. If you're leaving because you can't handle it?
No, I can handle it. I handled it last time. This is time I need with my mother.
Alicia, what are you thinking?
I think family is the most important thing in the world. There's nothing you can ever put above family. I wouldn't have come out here to begin with. No matter whether my mother said, I want you to go, I would have never came. Ever.
Jenna admits her mistake.
No, oh, yeah, I know
everybody
she does.
Makes it.
She admits her mistake.
But I wouldn't have come.
How about you, Amber? Boston Rob.
Well, I don't think it's right to even question her motives. We don't know what she's thinking. Or how she's feeling.
This is a big action with big consequences, and it could have a big impact on this game. We had an immunity challenge that we don't need to run now. Shapira, Saboga, you get off easy in a sense. You get a free pass today. Nothing at stake. You're going back to camp. Mogo Mogo, from a game point of view, it hurts you. This is a game about numbers. You only have 6 to begin with. You are now down to 5. That increases your chances of being voted out at the next tribal council.
But ironically, just a couple episodes later, after milking over Jenna's right decision to quit, he took the brunt of Sue's wrath after he treated Rich's actions against Sue as no big deal.
Oh, baby! You can't write no more!
Want some?
Good job. Yeah,
want
right.
Some, honey?
He's saying,
yeah.
Like
go ahead,
on.
Buddy. You got it, Kat.
Guys, come on. Nobody cares about that stuff.
Yeah, we don't, Richard.
Before we get to today's challenge, I want to address something that happened yesterday. Richard Hatch, sort of being inappropriate.
Sort of, yeah.
Anybody have any comments?
I was sexually violated. To have some guy come up, he passed a half a dozen people on platforms and never touched them.
Sue, I'm...
And it went too far, and he crossed the line, and he crossed the line with me.
Well...
Okay, I know you don't know. And you didn't see it because his back was to you, and he's too big of a slob to see around. I was violated, humiliated, dehumanized, and totally spent, Jeff. It wasn't sort of, Jeff, because his back was to you, Jeff. That's all I'm saying, and I'm spent, and I'm done with this game. There's no way I can continue with my emotions pushed to the ground that much.
So, okay, so when you say you're done with the game, as in, you want out of the game?
I'm done. I'm walking away.
And again, as Sue even said herself, Jeff didn't really see what Rich did, so you can't blame him too much for not stepping in more. But still, you can't deny how bad he looked here during this whole uncomfortable incident, especially when he made a bigger deal out of Jenna's quit to be with her ailing mother just a couple episodes prior. In Season 14, Survivor Fiji, poor Anthony not only got a bad draw, as he was the geeky nerd type all alone with a bunch of jocks, but the big guys didn't even try to make him a part of the group and outcasted him from the start, with Rocky being the worst culprit.
No, guy, here's the thing. I talk to people who talk to me. I sit down like men.
You call me not a man.
I didn't say that.
Dude, you've done it before.
Grow a spine, bro.
Dude, you've done it
Seriously.
Before, Rocky.
Like a jellyfish. Toughen up.
No,
I don't know what's going on in your mind, guy, but you act like a little girl sometimes, okay?
Once again.
You're effeminate.
I'm effeminate.
Toughen
up.
I'm
sorry.
Bro.
Oh, please. No.
Toughen up.
This is why I don't say anything.
Keep going, man. Fight for what's yours. Take the skirt off a little bit. Let's go.
Yet, despite Anthony pretty much getting bullied, Jeff, for some reason, took the bully's side and also ragged on Anthony instead of trying to stop the harassment.
So maybe if you take some of those words, you can use them later on in your life or tomorrow or the next day or 10 minutes from now, whenever you want to. You know what I mean?
Anthony, pretty candid advice. And still, you're just sitting there. What is so hard for you about speaking up and owning your own space? Alex, why were your hands buried in your head? Why is this bad?
You know, I was thinking to myself, wow, that is some tough love. I feel bad because I think what he said might have hurt Anthony's feelings. To be honest, that would hurt my feelings. So I just felt bad for the guy. And that's all I felt was empathy. That's it.
Anthony, Rocky could easily just kiss your ass and say, yeah, you're a good guy, Anthony, don't worry about it, and write your name down. What are you feeling right now?
I appreciate all of the advice about standing up for myself. What I don't appreciate is the name calling.
Do you want to be in this game?
Yes, I want to be in this game.
Anthony, the tribe has spoken. Time for you to go. Good luck.
If there was ever a time for one of Jeff's snarky comments, this would have been the perfect moment for one of them to shut Rocky up. But not only did he let Rocky basically attack Anthony, but he also seemed to side with Rocky through it all, and then asked Anthony a bunch of dumb questions, like why he couldn't stand up for himself, or if he really wanted to be there. Like, Jeff, put yourself in Anthony's shoes for a moment, and imagine pretty much being outcasted and harassed for 3 days. You probably wouldn't be that motivated either. At the reunion show in Survivor China, there was so much to talk about. Todd and Amanda's amazing gameplay, James's iconic run, PG's underdog story, and in general, we could learn more about arguably the greatest newbie cast in Survivor history. But instead, Jeff devoted the precious time he had at the reunion show to ask Courtney and Eric some rather personal questions. And all I can say is, if you cringe easily, turn off the video now.
Let's talk about the thing that was probably the most common question about you is your weight, the weight issue. You started this at 93 pounds. That was your starting weight. You came off the show at 86 pounds, so you lost 7% of your body weight. Anorexic eating disorder, what's the deal? Answer the question.
Well, Jeff, this is something I've just gotten in my entire life, all through high school. It was very, like, you know, very popular to, you know, health teachers were always all over me. And, you know, it's just, I come from a small family. I saw my dad on the show. He's tall and thin. My brother's in the audience. He's built just like me, too. Hey, Brad. And, you know, that's just the way it is. I don't really get too bent out of shape about it, whatever.
And your weight now is actually more than what it was when the show started.
Yeah, Jeff, thanks.
I guess that wasn't the best thing to say.
Jeff Probst just called me fat.
So, Eric, on the show, it's very clear that you are a virgin. So it begs the question, Eric, dating Jamie, are you still a virgin? Of course. All right.
I mean, there's no other way around this one. I don't care how many people on the streets wanted to know. You don't ask these kind of questions to people in front of millions watching. And this is usually regarded as Jeff Probst's worst moment in his Survivor career. Sticking with bad reunion show moments, let's go back to Survivor Vanuatu, when Chris overcame the 6-1 Women's Alliance to win Survivor. One of these women that Chris beat was Julie Berry, who was dating Jeff at the time of the reunion show. And keep in mind, Vanuatu is the season directly after All-Stars, when Jeff's OG crush, Boston Rob, lost due to a bitter jury for his cutthroat gameplay that was similar to Chris's game. So between seeing his love lose the year prior, and his current girlfriend lose to a guy that played very similar to Boston Rob, but this time actually got the win, Jeff took every chance he got to take a jab at Chris.
Julie,
yes.
He pays you back by putting his arm around you, stroking your hair, and then cutting your throat. Eliza,
basically the same story. Yep. He comes to you and says, never broken my alliance. He does the same thing. Little pat on the back, rub the shoulders, pull out the knife, boom, you're gone.
Yep. Most of the time said the truth, but you lied like a dog and you won.
Yep.
Is that what you're saying?
I think that's pretty clear at this point. And when he comes home, what does he tell you?
That he got voted on that night.
Oh, he did?
Yes.
So he let you believe that happened.
Yes.
So he's...
Yes. He did.
So first of all, Chris just got outed for telling you something, but it was a lie. So he's going to say it's okay because that's his character. We already know that.
Right. Yes.
Jeff has always been bad about letting his obvious biases show, but crapping on a guy who just won $1 million in one of the biggest underdog runs ever might just be his worst look ever when it comes to being an unbiased host. After making a scene out of Heather's terrible performance in Survivor 41, people were upset about the whole thing, as they missed Jeff being sassy and making fun of people who sucked at challenges. However, after the way Jeff targeted Katie of all people in Philippines, I think I can understand now why Jeff has toned it down a bit.
Go, Tandang! Alabama off to a slow start. Katie really slowing him down on a very easy portion of this challenge. A huge setback for Calabal. Here comes Calabal. Katie once again last one over. Katie struggling.
Go!
Calabal on their last bit of rope trying to get through that drawbridge. Still suffering from the beginning with Katie. Tandang with a big head start, and it still goes back to the first leg of this challenge. Katie could not get over the mound.
Katie, at today's challenge, miserable start for the tribe on your shoulders.
Absolutely. I feel like the biggest idiot in the world.
I mean, the poor girl had a below average performance at worst in one challenge, and Jeff didn't let her forget. It's almost amazing that Katie wasn't the one to go home that episode. I mean, we've seen plenty of worse performances throughout the years that Jeff didn't go nearly as hard on. But because Jeff didn't like Katie for whatever reason, he ragged on her nonstop and made a girl who slipped a bit a massive scapegoat. We've also seen Jeff throughout the years call out people for being bad at the game or being a boring character. But the thing is, he has a lot to do with casting these people in the first place.
Susie, I have one question for you, and as my friend says, whenever you say no disrespect intended, it means there probably is some. How did you get so far in the game? How did you get 3 votes and nearly win this game? I have to say, I was shocked at the votes.
I was shocked too.
As I was looking through them, you know, going, another Susie, another, I thought, is she gonna win this game?
And faced with a choice to vote out a strong member, Jackie, or a weak one, Kelly, they acted as though they had a death wish and weakened their tribe yet again.
You were voted out seconds into the game. You're now on a tribe of people who've played before you've never played. Do you belong out here?
JPE gave a really interesting answer to a very specific question by saying nothing. I don't see anybody else playing as laid back right now as JP.
Lydia, I'm gonna ask you the question that I asked you, bless your heart, at almost every tribal council. Sooner or later, I would say, Lydia, how are you still in this game?
But in the end, like I originally said, Survivor wouldn't be what it is today without Jeff, and despite his terrible biases, ragging of players unfairly, and other very uncalled for moments, these bad moments are nothing compared to all the great he's done for Survivor. Thank you guys so much for watching, and let me know in the comments if I missed any other bad moments from Jeff in his Survivor career. If you like what you see, then smash that like and subscribe button, and I will see you guys next time.